Death Valley is hot. Really hot. Like world record hot. People come here just to experience how hot it is. But there's also a specific reason for this heat. A specific combination of factors which turns an already hot and dry place into an even hotter and drier one. It has to do with climate, geology, and botany, all of which combine in a recipe that's perfect for extreme heat. And speaking of, let's talk a little bit more about that heat, because it is extreme and it is unique. Death Valley is home to the hottest ever recorded air temperature on the face of the earth, 134 degrees Fahrenheit at Furnace Creek in 1913. Now, there are a couple disputes about this record. Death Valley holds this record after a hotter temperature in Libya from 1922 was found to be inaccurate. But this record itself has also come into question given how old it is and the potentially inaccurate equipment that was used to record it. But for now, that record still stands and it's still official, so Death Valley is still the hottest place in the world. But it's not just record highs here either. Average temperatures from May through September are regularly over 100 degrees Fahrenheit. In 2001, the park saw 154 consecutive days with temperatures over 100 degrees. The summer of 1917 saw 43 days in a row with temperatures over 120 degrees. In 1996, the park had 105 days over 110 degrees and 40 days over 120 degrees. And if the air temperature isn't bad enough, let's talk about ground temperature. Because in 1972, Furnace Creek recorded a ground temperature of 201 degrees Fahrenheit. To put that into perspective, water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit. And let's keep going on this too, because it's not just heat. Death Valley is dry. Bone dry. Not including the nearby mountains, Death Valley regularly sees rainfall amounts less than 2 inches per year. In both 1929 and 1953, no measured rainfall was recorded. Between 1931 and 1934, Death Valley received less than an inch of total rainfall. All of this isn't even to mention the fact that Death Valley is the lowest point below sea level in all of North America, and the eighth lowest point in the world. It's also the largest national park in the lower 48 states. So, Death Valley is a land of extremes. It's hot, it's dry, and it's low. And a specific set of circumstances comes together to explain why Death Valley is so extremely hot. And in order to understand that fully, we need to talk about three things: geology, climate, and vegetation, in that order. Let's start with geology. Death Valley is what is known as a graben, or rift valley. This type of valley is formed by the movement of a block of land downward on either side of two other blocks of land moving upward. This movement is the result of parallel normal faults, which primarily move vertically. This sort of geologic process is what created many of the rift valleys in this area, which is known as the Great Basin. But Death Valley has something a little bit more complex going on too. In addition to those two normal faults, which are already causing the valley to sink, there's a strike-slip fault running the length of the valley, pulling it apart at the same time the normal faults are forcing it down. This combination of faults is what causes Death Valley to sink so low. Now, we've already talked about many of Death Valley's extremes, but here's another one to put this into perspective. Mount Whitney, the highest point in the lower 48 states, is less than 100 miles from Death Valley, the lowest point. This means there is a lot of elevation change in a relatively short distance, which is where climate then comes into play. Death Valley's extreme dryness is the result of a very extreme rain shadow effect. A rain shadow is created when moisture-rich clouds are blown into the mountains by prevailing winds, are forced upward, and due to decreasing pressure, drop their moisture on the front and top of the mountain. Now that the clouds have no moisture, when they make it to the other side of the mountain, they have no more rain to drop. Thus, this side of the mountain is incredibly dry. Now, back to those Death Valley extremes, because there isn't just one mountain range between Death Valley and the ocean. There are four. And so the rain shadow effect here is very extreme. And that's where our final topic comes into play, vegetation. Now, plants obviously need water to grow. But that extreme rain shadow effect makes water hard to come by in Death Valley. It doesn't mean there's no water, just not a lot of it. And that makes it very hard for plants to grow. Of course, plants do grow here. Death Valley is home to over 1,000 species of plants, most of which are adapted for extreme heat and little water. But in the salt pans of Badwater Basin, there's nothing, no life to speak of. And that only compounds the extreme heat. Here's why. Let's tie this all back together and see how each of these three factors contributes to why Death Valley is so hot. The heat from the sun beams down into the valley, and because it's so dry, there's no vegetation to absorb the solar energy. Instead, it gets reflected right back, but can't escape the valley because of how steep it is. The hot air cools ever so slightly and returns to the valley floor, only for this process to repeat itself. And to top it all off, Death Valley is aligned in a north-south direction, but winds blow in from the west, meaning they don't displace the hot air that has settled here. And so all of that hot air just sits in the valley floor, layering hot air on top of hot air. Essentially, the heat is just trapped here, destined to be caught in a never-ending cycle of extreme heat. Extreme heat, which is a product of extreme circumstances and an extreme environment. These three factors, geology, climate, and vegetation, all combine in a perfect storm to produce some of the hottest temperatures Earth has ever seen. And that is why Death Valley is so hot. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about the world's projected places, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.